for a good time.
Guys,
hi.
It's hi there.
Hi.
It's Darren
and Brittany.
We're eclectic souls.
Yes,
it's been a while.
It's been a while.
Yeah,
it's been a while.
But like a fine holiday, coming back to see your relatives again.
We're back.
It's a great feeling.
Yes.
Speaking of relatives.
Yes.
Yesterday we actually had it.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Oh yeah. So, speaking of relatives, yesterday, it's your great-grandmother, is that correct?
Yeah.
100 years old.
Yeah, we had her birthday party.
Her birthday party was yesterday. When's her actual birthday?
Her actual birthday, it was on Thursday.
That's so awesome.
Yeah.
100 years old.
100 years old.
She's seen so much.
Yeah, she has.
Oh my gosh. But, amazing lady, super sweet. She doesn't look
doesn't. She's aged gracefully.
At all.
She's aged really gracefully.
Basically, you'll see some pictures. We're going to put a couple videos, a couple pictures following this, just to kind of showcase the event, highlight the event a little bit.
Yeah.
But it was really great.
It was. So one of the things that I want to do in honor of my grandmother, and I'm sorry to continue to play with my hair. It is extremely windy out here.
It is.
But I wanted to talk about a couple of things that I've learned from her.
Uh-huh.
And I think that you can do the same thing. Darren has known her for a very small amount of time, especially in comparison to how long I've known her. But he's known her for a little bit of time. So there are two things that I wanted to share that I learned from my grandmother. One is her love for everyone. Like, if she meets you for the first time, she's like, oh my gosh. She's really excited and really happy to see you. Like, she loves everyone. And, like, it's not like a whole, like, oh, I'm going to act like I'm happy to see them, but then I'm going to talk about them when they leave. Like, she's, like, genuinely happy to see you, and she's so loving. And even as a kid, I always felt, like, just so, appreciated when I was in her presence. Just for, like, sitting next to her, just talking to her. It was really awesome. And we wouldn't talk about anything deep. Sometimes we talk about, like, peanut butter and banana sandwiches. Or we talk about tomato and mayonnaise sandwiches. But it was just the best time. And she really just taught me a lot about loving other people. And genuinely, just being a beautiful person inside and out. And another thing, like, she's such a prayer warrior. Like, even to this day, she loves to praise God. She loves to pray. And it doesn't matter what's going on in her life. I think she's lost maybe 3 children. Some maybe miscarriages and stuff like that, but then others dramatic accidents, like car accidents and stuff. She's always still very grateful for life. She's always so happy, and she's always praying, and she's always praising God, and she's never lost that fervor and that zeal for life, even though she's dealt with some very, very hard things, and she lost her husband, but she still finds other things to be thankful for. She's so grateful. Even, when you go by her house and go see her, she's like, thank you for coming. Thank you for coming to see me. Thank you guys for coming to celebrate my birthday. She's one of the most grateful people that I know. And she also she really starts with God. Like, she really just starts off her gratitude with God, and then it just flows out to other people. She taught me the power of prayer and the power of praise. I just love sitting next to her and listening to her pray, because it's so powerful. And she truly believes in what she's saying. She truly believes in the power that God holds. And it just makes me want to be closer to God, honestly. She's a wonderful woman. And I'm so glad we still have her here. I'm so glad that she's 100. What a milestone. I was so glad, so honored to be a part of that party.
Me too.
And it was so nice. It was the best.
It was
the best. Shout out to Aunt Janice, Tamika, my Aunt Treba, my Aunt Issy, my Aunt Stacy, my Aunt Mary, my Aunt Lisa, Shan. Daphne, you guys did a tremendous job. I know there are some other people that helped too, Aunt Marva. You guys did a really, really good job putting everything on. I know my mom did a lot of stuff with the MC. She did the programs. She really helped to plan the event and bring it together. Mom, you did an incredible job. To all of my relatives that helped, I just want to say thank you. I love you. I'm so glad that I was able to see you guys last night. And yeah,
Awesome.
What did you learn from
your mom? I think just having like that joy and that gratitude, like you were saying. The one thing that I think stood out, maybe your cousin or one of your aunts mentioned that, like, anytime she sees somebody or somebody comes to visit, she's always like, yay!
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Kenya said that.
Yeah, and so...
Shout out to Kenya. I love you, Kenya.
Awesome. But just being excited like that, sometimes our, if we're working through something or our circumstance, like, we allow it to get us down, but it also, I think, sometimes can affect how we interact with it.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like... We should always have that excitement and that joy to see that person, mm-hmm. you know? And I think that's something that I could really take away from that. And just like, you know, making it a point that whenever I see somebody, like just making sure that they know that, you know, it's an exciting moment for them to be seen, you know? Because I think it's important to let people know that they are valued and that they are important. Because you may be the only person, you know, that takes time to... be excited about their presence or, you know, even just reach out to them. So I guess that's probably my key takeaway on that.
Awesome. That's awesome. I'm glad you said that.
Yeah.
So a couple of things. I also like to, like, give shout outs to people. I have on a really long necklace.
Ooh.
Let's make that stand up just a little bit so you can see it. It's like that long. And this necklace, I actually won this necklace from a friend of mine who has a jewelry company. It's like Jazzanuga Accessories. You should look her up on Facebook and like it. And if you're looking for Christmas gifts and stuff like that, you should definitely check her out. I absolutely love this necklace. I love long pieces. So mm-hmm. she has long pieces, short pieces, stuff for kids, all kind of stuff. So look her up, check her out. And then lastly, drum roll. We're doing a giveaway.
Yes.
We're doing a giveaway during the month of December. All you have to do is like share one of our videos, your favorite video that we made, and also subscribe. So you have to share the video, subscribe, comment on whatever video that you share, and then like tell your friends about it. Tell your friends.
Tag us in it as well.
Yeah, tag us in it. Tag your friends so that they can subscribe too. And then at the end, on like January. At the end, around like December 24th, maybe 25th, because we want to do it around Christmas time, mm-hmm. we are going to give away a $50 gift card of some sort. Maybe like Amazon or Walmart or, you know, just maybe a Visa. So you can kind of choose whatever you want to do with it. But we're going to give that away to you. I don't want you guys to miss out. For those of you who have been with us from the beginning, always leaving comments, always sharing stuff. What's that guy's name? He's really nice.
Michael?
Michael, yes, Michael. Mm-hmm. To you, Michael. Shout out to Michael. People like that, we appreciate you. Please do this so that you can enter the drawing so we can pick someone. And yeah, we love you guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Absolutely.
Hope you guys are having a great holiday.
And when you're in Chattanooga, come visit the Hunter Art Museum so you can see this driftwood horse. It's actually a horse, isn't it? That's its
it
tail
is.
End.
Mm-hmm.
Horse's
with
ass.
The arse.
I'm down here, you horse's ass.
Watch anyway. Home Alone next chance you get.
Okay. Bye. Love
Bye.
You.